by a great writer, Cicero. A room without books is a body without soul. Namaskar, respected teachers and all my dear friends. Here, I warmly welcome our ex-Bhavanite, Knight of Pens, novelist, blogger and the writer of two books, Junior Detectives, Case of the Missing Books and The Ultimate Mischief Destination. I am extremely delighted to announce that at this small age of 16 years, she is a literary pioneer. She is none other than Disha Mangal Didi. She aims to pen down quality literature and spread the goodness of reading and writing among young children like us. With her quality experiences from Katha Utsav, National Literary Workshops and many more, she has joined us today for guiding us on story improvisation and creative writing skills. Now soon, I would like to hand over to Disha Mangal Didi, who had been instrumental to the school's journey. She possesses so many awards, certificates and performed many duties during her school time, as well as she performed extremely well in class 12 this year. Without taking much of your time, I would like to invite an outstanding speaker to deliver her talk and enlighten us. Please welcome her with a big round of applause.
Thanks a lot, Meghna, for the lovely introduction that you gave. I would also first like to thank all my teachers who invited me to interact with you all. It's always like a feeling of homecoming when we come to the school or when we interact with the young Bhavanites. So, Namaskar, everybody. Can we just put our mics off and greet each other? Namaskar, everybody.
Namaskar.
That shows that you have not been trained enough by your day's class. Huh? We still have that energy. All right, so today we have gathered here to not just do creative writing or not just write stories. We have actually gathered here to live one of our wildest dreams. One of our dreams which we have always thought about once or the other, one time or the other, but we have never got to put that dream into practice or dream into reality. So just a second, I'll share my window. So the dream is the PPT visible to everybody?
Yes,
Didi. Yes, Didi. Yes,
the PPT is visible?
Yes,
all right.
So
the dream I've been talking about was that if I was a god, or if I would say if I could create a world. Have we all thought about this one time or the other?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sometimes.
So, like, we all have fantasized about it one time or the other, but like, do we ever get to put those fantasies into practice? I'm sure none of us has ever got this opportunity or ever tried to do this in a more reality way. So, like, why not do this today and now? And one way would be to be a storyteller. So here I welcome you all, creators of your own universes, to be gods, to be magicians, to be storytellers. So are you ready to be creators?
Yes.
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 Are you story writers?
Yes.
Yes.
So now as we all have identified ourselves as writers and storytellers, let's move on to the next step. That is quite interesting. That is writing a story. So we are going to do a quick activity here. What we'll do is, on the count of three, as I say three, you'll type a word in the chat box and we'll try to create a story out of it. Is everybody ready?
Yes.
You can write any word. You have to type it in the chat box and send it as I say the number three. All right? So you can write any word, any noun, any character, any object, even your phone, even your laptop, anything that you can think of or anything you would like to make a story on. We'll pick one word out of all of them and we'll try to create a story. All right. When I say the number three, then you have to post the word. All right. So should I start the counting?
Yes, Didi.
All right, so yes, one, 4, 9, 10, 6, and 3. All right. Words are coming up.
Ma'am, Lakshita has written 4.
All right, so we have got a lot of Harry Potter and BTS fans here. Keyboard. Ah, I like this one.
I have written keyboard.
Ah, that's a very interesting thing. Are we done? Has everybody sent?
Yes, ma'am, I have written.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so I like the word keyboard a lot. What if we talk about a story like an autobiography of the keyboard? What about it? What do you think about it? Will it be a good topic to build on?
Ma'am, we can do everything with keyboard.
Yeah, exactly. So why not write about like a day in life of keyboard, the autobiography of a keyboard. Does everybody agree with me?
Yeah, Didi.
Yes, Didi.
Yes.
All right. So I'll give the start line.
It's quite interesting.
Yes, it is very interesting. So let me start with the first sentence of the story. And then we can pick up students and you can continue the story forward. Is it okay with everybody?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. So let's start. I'm starting the story. I was typing furiously on my keyboard when suddenly there was a sound from the keys. Should I repeat? I was furiously typing on the keyboard while suddenly some sound started coming from the keys, from underneath the keys. Yes, who would like to continue the sentence? Yes.
Didi, I
can... yes, you can continue it. Say.
Then keyboard start working and dancing.
All right. So
and
the keyboard
song on keyboard.
Didi, can I?
Yes, Peter, say.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, Didi, we can do our work on keyboard with type.
We can even chat in the chat box with the help of keyboard.
Yes.
And we can play game also on keyboard. Then it suddenly.
See, there are so many aspects of the keyboard.
Then it suddenly started.
Didi, can I?
Just a second. I would request you all to just put your mics off. Just for once. All right. So now, instead of putting everybody on unmute, because it is becoming a bit chaotic on this online platform, is it okay if I pick anybody?
Yes.
Yeah. So the story has gone from like I was furiously tapping on my keyboard when there were voices coming from underneath the keys. The keys started coming out. They started dancing, and they were all cheering up. All right, we have reached here. So okay, the faces that I can see. Pearl Khandelwal. All right, can you extend the story?
Yes, Didi. I was scared that how can they dance and sing music? Then my sister was also dancing with them.
All right. All right, so we have included our sister in it, and now seeing the keys, we got scared, and because the keys were dancing, our sister has also started dancing with the keys. All right, so next sentence. Peter, can you extend the story?
Yes. I asked my sister, you are not scared of these keyboards if they are dancing? I can't believe. The sister said, "No, I love to dance. I can dance with anybody."
All right. Next, Adhiraj, can you extend the story next?
Suddenly, an enter key appeared at front of me, saying, "Enter with." Enter with me. I will take you to the world of the keyboard.
Can you just repeat it, Adhiraj? It isn't clear.
Your presentation is stopped because Manish has started presenting. So we can't see your presentation.
No, ma'am, I have not presented.
All right. Now you're able to see it?
Yes,
Adhiraj, continue.
Suddenly, an enter key appeared in front of me. Unexpectedly, that asked me to enter in me. I will take you to the world of the keyboard.
All right, that's a nice twist. So the keys are welcoming us.
Please don't present your screen. Lakshita, please tap on it. Use your chat box. Students, please use your chat box. And don't present your screen.
Yes, so Adhiraj has a proposed a nice twist to the story. So now the keys are inviting us to the world of keyboards, the world of computers. So like now, who will be the next?
Me.
Prakalp Sharma. Prakash yes. Sharma. Can you extend the story?
Yes. Then I enter and press the enter key.
All right.
My sister come in world of keys.
All right.
Everywhere there are keys, trees of keyboard, lakes of keyboard.
Wow, that was nice.
And chocolates are also off keyboard.
Very nice. All right. Lakshita, can you extend the story next?
Yes. Then I was so much excited to see that there are also the rivers of keys. There are so many keys in the river, and we can see the chocolate in the chocolate pieces, the letters were written, and even we can even we can type the letters in the keyboard.
All right, nice one. So like now we have reached the world of keyboard. There are keys everywhere, there are rivers of keys. Are you
Excuse
saying
me.
Anything, Rajwardha?
Someone is writing continuously in the chat.
You want to say something?
No.
All right. So we have reached the world of keyboard, and there are keys everywhere. There are rivers of keys. There are chocolate of keys. So now let me add something to it. So the enter key takes us to the king of the kingdom. And there, the king of the keyboard kingdom meets us and tells us humbly that, please, can you use me a little softly so that my subjects, my people, the keys on your keyboard aren't hurt much. We just called you here because you were tapping on us so furiously and so hardly that all our backs are paining right now. With this, we understood our mistake. We bowed to the king of the keyboard kingdom, and we once again went back to our room, and we promised our keyboard to use it nicely. So, have we created a story?
Didi, we can add one thing. Then I get wake up that I was see that it's I was sleeping and that's what my dream.
It's a dream.
Yeah, we can add that as well. That can be a different ending as well. So let's put it like we came back and we were suddenly woken up by our alarm clock and we got to know that it was a dream. And so Didi, there we have created. Yes.
We can also add one more thing in between the story that the king of the power, the king of the buttons was the power button, and he first requested her to sit down and talk. So he started talking that, do you know that why in the keyboard the alphabets are not arranged equally and like that. So after their talk, he said that you should use the keyboard wisely.
Yes. There's so many elements that we can add to the story. Just like I told you, we all are creators. We all create something. So we can all create some or the other details in the story which can be helpful and make it more interesting.
Mama, yes?
Yeah, that can be another interesting detail in the story.
Ma'am, can I also
Didi? Didi, we can add Didi, we can add a mouse also and king.
We can add. Very nice. We are all bubbling with ideas right now. Yes.
Yes.
So let's put a pause to the story here, and let me introduce you to something different right now. So now, now that we have created a story, so why don't we improvise it? Improvising it to make it a better story, to transform it into a better story. So here I am. So here I am providing you with some interesting techniques to improvise your story. So STORY, story. The word itself is a very good mnemonic to remember some techniques. Are you saying something?
Didi, I am saying it is so decorate story.
Yeah. So STORY, the word itself, is a very good mnemonic to remember techniques of story improvisation. So if we start with S. S stands for the start. So we all know that the start of the story is one of the most toughest thing to write. And it takes up the most energy, the most ideas, the most creativity. And a good trick to start the story with something that appeases to one of the five senses is always a good option. The five senses: the eyes, the nose, the ears, the touch, and the taste. If the start of your story appeases to any of these five senses, it makes the story more communicative, and you can communicate with the readers in a better way. For example, if we have to start the story, if you are writing a story and you have to start it with a scene where a girl is standing in the rain. All right. So instead of just simply writing it that a girl was standing in a rain, we can use the sense of sound. For example, we can write pitter patter, the drops were giggling as they fell on the girl's umbrella. Yes, is it better than just simply writing a girl was standing in the rain?
Yes, Didi.
Yes, it is better.
Yes, it is better.
Yeah.
Didi is much better than that.
So here we use the element of sound. What if we use the element of smell? We all know the soil, the moist soil in the rainy season, it smells so sweet. So you can use the element of smell here. The sweet smell of moist sand covered the girl like a blanket. Yeah. And we can even use the element of sight. The element of sight, a rainbow adorned the girl's.
Didi, I have not understood.
You didn't understood the smell part?
Didi, how can we use element of
sight? Understand. Didi, ab dobara bataoge?
Just a second. Should I repeat it?
Okay, Didi. Yes, Didi, you can repeat.
So I was telling you that you should start your story with something that is related to the five senses. That can be through hearing, the ears, nose, the smell, and eyes, sight. For example, if we have to start a story which shows a girl standing in the rain. All right. So instead of just writing that a girl was standing in the rain, what we can do is, we can start with the noise of droplets on the girl's umbrella. Maybe the girl is carrying an umbrella. So we can start with the noise. Yes? Can you repeat it? What you said, Manish?
Nidhi, sorry.
So we can start the story with the sound of droplets that are pouring down on the girl's umbrella. For example, pitter patter or tip tip or dip drop, the droplets were pouring down on the girl's head or the girl's umbrella. So what it does, it creates a more bigger and a more clearer picture of a girl standing in the rain. Similarly, if we like, we have always noticed that the soil, it smells really sweet in the rainy season. So what if we start our story like the girl was surrounded with the sweet smell of moist sand or moist soil. So that adds a very much reality aspect to your story. It makes it more clearer to the reader that what you are wanting to express. We got it now? Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, Didi.
Yes.
Yes, Didi.
Yes, Didi.
All right. So now, like accommodating these elements of senses, it helps you make that clearer image of the scene you want to describe. So if we move on. It's cracking?
No,
Didi, your voice is clear.
It's coming clear.
No, it's clear.
Didi, your voice is clear.
Now it's clear.
All right. So now we start with T. So T stands for theme. Like every story contains a theme. Yeah? So, and it is very important.
Some students are presenting. So
whatever problem you are facing, now write down in the chat box. Please don't interrupt in between.
Okay, sorry.
All right, now you can see. Now we can All right. So I was talking about the theme part. So like every story, it contains a theme. And it is very important for a writer to stick to a particular theme in the story. Like mingling many themes can get a bit interesting sometimes, but it actually makes the writing process and the reading process a bit cumbersome. And the writer, by mingling many themes together, is actually not able to deliver the message in depth to the reader. So whenever you write, pick a single theme. It can be science fiction, it can be comedy, or it can be a mystery genre. It can be anything. But my suggestion would be to stick to a particular theme. All right? So now we move on to O, that stands for omit. So now omitting is for omitting extra details. So,
Didi?
Ma'am, do we have time in here or I wanted to do an activity in here. Do we have that much time? Pooja ma'am?
Yes.
All right. So now I want you all to do an activity. I want you all to write your autobiography in 40 words.
Didi, how to write autobiography?
Just try to describe yourself. Let's put it this way. just try to describe yourself in, let's make it more precise. Try to express yourself in 30 words. Exact 30 words.
Did he have, what is the meaning of omit? O-M-I-T.
Are we all doing it?
Didi, we can...
Didi?
Didi, we can... Didi, we can introduction ourselves.
Yes, you can. You have to write about yourself in exact 30 words. Do it quickly, quickly.
Do we have to use these theme, start and omit these things?
No. Abhi, I'm just asking you to introduce yourself or describe yourself in 30 words. Okay. All right. So now, have you all done?
Didi, please. 2 minutes.
All right, no, I'll give you one more minute.
You give some time, sir. Okay.
Didi, can I?
Wait. I'll tell you what to do now. Yes. So now that we have written about ourselves in 30 words, I want you to make it 20 words. The same thing that you have written, I want you to cut out all the unnecessary things. And make it to 20 words.
My name is
Didi. Didi, if we introduce ourselves, so in the starting, we can write this hello everyone.
It isn't necessary. You can directly start with I am Aradhya Maharishi.
But I have written hello everyone.
Didi, can I tell?
Just a second.
5.
Keep it to yourself right now. Yes, Adhiraj, you want to say something? Keep it to yourself. We need to be a bit precise with this activity, otherwise it will be taking a lot of time. All right, so I hope majority of us have done this activity.
Yes, so, Didi, done.
Yeah. So, so like we saw how
Didi done.
It was. So, express ourselves.
11, 12, 13, 14, 17, 18,
19, 20. Yes, Didi, I done.
Yeah. So we saw how difficult it was to first express ourselves in just those 30 words. Yeah. But eventually we ended up defining ourselves in just 20 words. Yeah. This is because sometimes the details we think are important are not actually necessary. What's more, omitting the extra details kind of tightens your story together, your message, and it makes it more compact and helps you convey the message to the reader in a few words. And due to this, if none of your words or none of your phrases are unnecessary details, then your every word gets equal attention from the reader. The reader has no option to just skip off some paragraphs or skip off some lines. So omitting all the unnecessary details in your manuscript helps you gather the reader's attention towards your each and every comma, towards your each and every letter of the word. And I think there's nothing more than proper attention to your manuscript that a writer wants more than anything like that.
Nidhi, or
yeah. So next we move on to R, that is read.
So it's not.
Now is it audible?
Yes, Didi, you are audible.
So like once we have written, once you have written your story, keep your pen aside and sit with your story for a while. Read it with the mindset of a reader. Try to recognize parts of the story where there needs to be more clarity or parts where there are unnecessary details. After reading your story thoroughly, quickly do the changes which you recognize. Like, this is a very important aspect of story improvisation, because we as writers write our stories with a different mindset. We know what we want to convey and we write the story according to that mindset. But actually, is it getting conveyed to the reader or not becomes a different thing. That is why reading the story after writing becomes a very important step in story improvisation. And the last one, why? What's your own story? So like everybody is a unique version, and every story is a unique version of you yourself. Every story is an insight into your unique minds and personality, your unique traits. Whether it's a story, it's an experience, it's a memory, anecdote, you would say, an imagination, or anything that you write. Even if it's an article, it's an essay, your story should reflect your own ideas. Just like the keyboard story we did. Everybody had different ideas. None of us had the same ideas. That is because every story, every idea is unique. A good writer is one who writes to express himself or herself without getting biased about how people are going to take it. You just have to be concerned that you convey all your ideas and whatever you want to convey to your readers. A good writer writes to express, not to impress. So now that we have learned about story improvisation, can we use a bit of it in improvising the story we created earlier, the keyboard one? Can we do that?
Yes.
All right. So I'll pick some of you and we can try it out. So Savita Avana.
Am I pronouncing? She is Disha.
All right, Disha. Yeah. So can you improvise the story that we created earlier? Like start, if I give you a hint, we started like we were furiously typing the keyboard. So my suggestion would be, can we add the element of touch here or the element of sound in here? Can we do that?
Yes.
Think of it. All right, let me give you a hint. What if we start with like, I was furiously thumping the hard keyboards, keys on my keyboard.
I have one more idea.
Say.
Tap, 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 tap. I was typing on the keyboards and suddenly...
Yeah, that's a nice one. That was nice, Javisha. Tap, tap, tap. I was tapping on the keyboard. Yes, that was nice. So, anybody else who would like to add some element of senses to other parts of the story?
Sehel.
Sehel, you want to add something?
Didi can add.
Didi, I can also add.
We'll
I can also add.
One by one.
We'll listen to everybody one by one. I'll ask everybody. Yeah. Say Pehel.
May I?
Yeah.
Tweet. Suddenly there was a sound from the keyboard and then suddenly the music started playing. And then all the keyboards, keys of the keyboard started dancing and singing.
All right. So we added some elements of hearing. Yeah. Little finger danced on keys.
Didi, can I?
Just a second. Let me include everybody. Yeah. Ishika Gautam.
Can I?
Yeah, can you add something?
Yeah.
Let Ishika add something.
Yeah, the little keys on the keypad dance like a thunderstorm on my floor. And my sister started dancing like a fairy at the home. It's mine.
Yeah.
That was mine.
All right. We'll Meghana Garg. Can you add something?
Yes, I can.
Didi, your voice is coming very slow.
Now is it all right? Am I audible?
Yeah, I'm audible.
Yes.
Yeah. Meghana Garg, say. What can you add to the story?
My sister also started struggling with the keys on the floor, but she was not at all scared. Rather, I was very scared from those keys.
All right, that's nice. All right, Pehel, you can type your answer in the chat box. No issues. All right, Rishita Gupta, can you add something?
Didi, can I?
Yeah, all right. Prakalp, you add something.
When my sister entered King Mouse Castle, he welcomed us with flowers of tea.
All right.
Can I add something?
Yes, Manas, say.
Didi, can I add?
When we entered the world of keyboard, we saw a huge kingdom of keyboard, and then some guards made of keyboard and asked us to move in.
All right, nice.
Didi, can I add?
Didi, can I?
Can I?
Didi, can I add?
Didi, can I? Didi, can you listen my voice?
Yeah, Pehel, say.
When the guards take us to the king's, king understood that we are from outside the world of keyboards, and after when we were writing on it from it, then accidentally we came into the kingdom.
All right.
Please, can I?
Yes, say. Adhiraj, say.
The king know that he have typed very fastly and furiously. And he tell the story of the bold king. It was the old time. And I want to...
Didi, can I...
We will continue.
Just a second,
It's a story of a typewriter. It was our first keyboard on the world. It has all alphabets in a same line. And people used to type very fastly through it. The typewriters died very badly. And a god came named QWERTY. He said, I will unalphabetically make you unalphabetically. And this makes the keyboards types very slow. And people used to type very slow.
So that look, Adhiraj has actually created.
And fingers dance on keys. It is related to this sentence.
I'm understanding that you all are bubbling with all these ideas. I would recommend you that we'll not be able to take up everybody's responses in here. So you can just write down your stories and share it with each other. You can even submitted for the school magazines and all. So we improvised the story we created through using the theme that was imagination. We used elements of senses, which helped the story appeal more to the reader. It made it more interesting. And with this, we come to the just a second.
Didi, I have written in Swedish, so it is correct. Our fingers is dancing on keyboards, and some sounds are coming
That can be added too. A lot of things can be added by simply accommodating those senses, the five senses that I told you about, a particular theme. Then you can simply read your story once again, improvise it. Understand what unnecessary details you need to omit, and you can make your story a better one. So with this, I thank you, everybody, and I hope you all love to be creators. And I also have some ideas for you.
Yes.
I also have some ideas for you. So you can, I have listed some characters and some ideas. And if you like, and if you want to write some stories on them, then do write stories on them. You can write stories. You can use the improvisation techniques, the STORY technique we learned about today. You can improvise your stories. You can make them better. And you can share it amongst you, your
people. And we can add elements of stories also in our stories.
Yes, obviously you can. So here are some ideas for you. If I'll leave this slide here, if you want to take a screenshot. So with this, I would like to end my presentation.
Yeah, thank you, Disha. It was really very informative session. I hope students will get benefit out of it. And now I want, Sarvesh sir, do you want to speak something or shall I ask Meghna to wind up?
Meghna will continue.
Sarvesh sir.
Meghna will continue, ma'am.
Okay, Meghna, you can continue.
Yes, ma'am. Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, Meghna.
Little bit so we can hear you.
You are audible but little loud.
Yeah, little bit audible.
Books to the ceiling, books to the sky. My piles of books are a mile high. How I love them, how I need them. I'll have a long beard till the time I read them. Namaskar. Best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such player among them. I, Meghna Garg of class 8D, consider it a golden opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to all who have witnessed it as a memorable event. It was indeed a privilege to have Disha Mangal Didi, ex-Bhavanite, the renowned writer and novelist, as a speaker in this thought-provoking session of creative writing on story improvisation. Today, my words are not enough to express the gratitude. On behalf of my friends and all the junior students, I would like to thank our speaker who graced us with her inspiring information. Her insightful tips on the same were full of wisdom and information. These tips will definitely help us to take up writing in future, and one day we may also be like her. Next, my heartfelt thanks goes out to all my teachers who thought me capable of this job and gave me this wonderful opportunity. We feel proud and thank you for making us feel happy with your presence in this function. I am sure everyone present here must be feeling privileged to be a part of this informative session. And I would like to say thank you to Sarvesh Sir and Pooja Ma'am for providing us this enlightened platform during this tough time of COVID-19 through online mode. Once again, I would like to thank Disha Mangal Didi for sparing her precious time for guiding us. Last but not the least, I thank all the students for showing their interest and involvement in this event. I would like to end my